What up, YouTube? You may notice that is not my black Model 3 behind me. No, that is something different. You might be wondering, did we upgrade to a Model S? Well, go ahead, hit that like button, subscribe to our channel, and I'm gonna answer that question for you. No, we didn't trade in Kanye. We love our Model 3 too much, but yes, we are in a Model S right now. We are in the 85D, and we are in this one because this is the loaner vehicle that Tesla gave us while our Model 3 is being worked on. And we just got a call from Victoria at the Tesla Center. She was super, super nice, and she told us our car is ready. So it's been in the service center for less than a day, and it is already ready to be picked up. We won't pick it up today simply because we already are on our way to go hiking, so we will pick it up on Monday. But let me tell you a little bit more about this Model S that we have here. You can see in the back, it's got the same setup with the three seats, of course. We've got J3 back there. Looks like he's sleeping right now. But there is a considerable more amount of space in the trunk area. And since it does have the hatchback setup, it's a lot easier to access things back there as well. Now, we think that this is probably maybe a 2015 or 2016 Model S. Simply because it does have the autopilot feature, which is something that isn't offered on the previous versions. But let me show you just a few more differences from this one compared to the Model 3 that we have. So let me flip that camera around. Biggest differences that we have is down here in the console area. If you can see, it's a really low console compared to the Model 3, which really comes up a whole lot higher and has different compartments. I think the Model 3 console is something that I prefer just because it does have those compartments. It's easier to access when you're driving. It even has more convenient cup holders that are up front, whereas the Model S has them all the way back here. But another big difference you'll see right off the bat is with the touchscreen. It's in a portrait mode here, which isn't bad. We don't mind that at all. We do just, I think, like the Model 3 because maybe that's what we're used to. But another difference that is pretty substantial here is the lag. And you'll see if I zoom out a little bit, it takes a little bit of time just for the map to catch up to itself. But not too bad at all. Just something that has been improved on since we have the Model 3. But you'll see also, you'll see these vents here. This is another huge difference. We've got, of course, two on either side for the passenger, just like a traditional vehicle would have. And you can just move them to adjust the verticalness or the horizontalness of the airflow. But the Model 3 has, of course, the singular vent that goes all the way across the dashboard, and you adjust that on the touchscreen. So just another difference, you can see that Tesla's come a long way from the Model S to the Model 3. And as I turn the camera here, you will see the door handles. This does have an actual door handle, whereas the Model 3, of course, has just the electronic button you push and it just swings right open. You can see down here, legroom-wise, there is a considerable amount of legroom. I don't think it's too different from the Model 3, but of course I have shorter legs than most people, I think. But very lastly here, going over to the driver's side, you'll see there is a heads-up display. We don't necessarily mind that. It's not a huge deal to us. I think for my husband, since he doesn't typically drive with his hands on 10 and 2, he more drives with his hand right there in the middle, as you can see. It does block his view, which leads us to the steering wheel, which is considerably bigger than the one on the Model 3. Just something, again, to get used to. Not good, not bad, just different. But looking here, you'll see one stalk on the right-hand side, and there are three stalks on the left-hand side. You've got the turn signal stalk, the autopilot stalk, and then a stalk to adjust the steering wheel. So Tesla did streamline that, moving to the Model 3, where that one only has the two stalks. It's got, of course, the one on the left for the turn signals, and then the one on the right that has a dual function as a gear stalk and then the autopilot stalk. So pretty different, but overall, still a wonderful vehicle.
Well,
Well, we're about a mile and a half into our hike here, and even though the weather report said it would be warm and sunny out, it's a little drizzly and it's getting pretty cold, so we're going to turn around and head back so J3 doesn't turn into an ice cube. I guess you could say the mountains here in Washington really are their own little ecosystem, but we're going to turn around and we're going to go put on our heated seats in the Tesla. Well, we have just loved driving this beautiful Model S this weekend. Take a look at those 22-inch rims there. Those are beauties. And that pearl white color just pops so much. But as much as we have loved driving this weekend, we are just super excited to get our Model 3 back from the service shop on Monday. But if you have any sort of experience with Tesla rentals or loaners, drop us a comment below and we'd love to hear about it.